Hi guys, how are you?
Good. Very good.
That was Dylan and there were a lot of major groups, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Everyone from many different cities. I want people to be very active and I'm sure you, most of you are very active indeed. So we'll do two ceremonies first and then I'll take you through this, okay? The first ceremony would be pat your woman's back, say, and say that glad you're here today. Pat your woman's back. Saturday morning. You able to hear me?
Yeah.
So pat your neighbor's back and say that glad you're here today. Do that. No, it's okay. Please.
Yeah. So,
how are you feeling now? Easy. So at least you know the next person who's there is feeling good, right? Okay. So now as we say, make your own rules. Arnold, for you, I'm doing this. Let's do one small exercise, one small ceremony. All the front people, they have to touch three people, behind, sitting only, they have to touch three people, and from those, they have to touch the person in the last. And once you reach, like, you reach elbow over there, you reach MLK Pichardo there, once you reach these two people, I'll grab. Okay? Let's do that. You have to touch three people. All the front. You start from the front to the back. Your time starts now. Some people are scanning, should I touch this person or not? Yeah. Okay, clap! Lot of time. You have like so many rooms, okay? Look at the amount of time. Don't you think so? So let's do this once again. Again, you have to do, but you have to touch elbow. So you need to think whom you need to touch so that you can be quick. Go on. Your two people. Let's see. I know the other. Quick! Now, you saw a little change. You made your own rules, right? So, this is our subconscious mind in the beginning, whenever we start anything. We are like open to new ideas. Sometimes we do not know exactly what we should do. But now, when we understand with one iterative cycle which we do, we understand we need to patch elbow. And that's how we thought of touching these people instead of you pointing out at somebody else. With this, I will also make your rules. With this, I will start channel social media and community. Hi, that's me. I'm Karan. I do not like to call myself an Agile coach. I call myself as Agile evangelist. The people who talk about Agile, all the things, whatever is there in the community and probably. Okay. So, what are the WIFMs right now? Some of you might have these WIFMs. Maybe. Some of you? Is it in farming? Anything? What are your expectations? Can I have a mark?
Yeah.
Okay. Meanwhile, any expectations, guys? Or are you ready for this experiment?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes?
There. Are you ready for this experiment?
Yes.
Okay. Wonderful. How many of you are aware of this?
Some of you,
maybe.
Everyone?
Almost
everybody.
Almost everybody, yeah. So that's your manifesto. I put it like I don't know, I go crazy with inspections, working. Okay. And, that's a short way to learn that. I don't see that. So instead of software, it's working software. I understand working software, but for me, I believe it can be tried anywhere else. Most important is working stuff. Okay, social media, it's an ocean. So how many of you are active out there on social media? Some of you? Yep. What platform do you follow? What one do channels? Twitter, Facebook? Any of your own? LinkedIn? Anybody else?
Pinterest?
Yeah, Pinterest. Great. Okay. Before I move on to this, I want to tell you something this topic went to Agile in social media. Now, when we talk to a person, when a person or a brand, when we look like, how do we, however, our steps So probably this might be, you know, a stepwise introduction how we go ahead and start doing the social media. This also follows the content pack, which we're not looking here, but I will take you through this thing. So content marketing is a social process. So one is analyze and observe. What you do, the first thing is understand the social climate. Probably whenever a brand starts, probably understand what it's doing right now. What are they right now? What is social climate probably? What are they working on? What you need to spend time with the person or with the brand to understand the social climate and analyze and observe. Build your online community. You need to understand what are things are there in place. You need to start your own online community to understand how you can connect with the people, the like-minded people. Like some of the communities are there, online communities. So that is second step. Develop your strategy and calendar. I'm going to touch base that. This might look a little general, but we're going to come up on the practical usage of this to be more comfortable with it. You need to develop your strategy. You need to understand the strategy and develop your own calendar. I just want to explore the social media calendars strategy. Create the value, your blog posts, your videos, photo elements, infographics, etc. Here is something which I want to touch base. See, here is where social media starts. Probably you get the word out. You understand exactly where you. These are all the social media channels. Some of you, as you mentioned, that you are familiar with Facebook. Some of you are on Twitter. So these are all the channels where probably all the social media people probably understand where they want to put their content up and where they want to spread the word. You need to monitor and engage. So monitor the online community. You need to join the discussions, respond and engage. Seven steps will be measure and analyze, where you review the metrics, you analyze the data, metrics are important everywhere, and make improvements. Then rinse and repeat. These are few steps how exactly how the ecosystem, social media platforms, from the content to your social strategy, and along with that, how it moves. As I mentioned before, you know how exactly the social calendar looks like. So if a person, I was talking to one team before, so they were saying that they have a Scrum dashboard like this. So basically, they have this 2 weeks. This is a brand page. I want to post good content so that I can get more followers. There are some of the to-do lists. So lots of teams nowadays are following the, visual display and probably these kind of boards where they're able to understand what they need to do. So like some of the brands, they comment 3 times in a day, comment. They tweet 1 or 2 times, they read following blogs and posts, they create a Twitter list, they write 1 guest blog, and then process what's happening. To verify some of your already aware, like you know, we understand retweets, we understand clicks, comments, mentions, the bounce rate, how many people really stay on the website, and how many not. Your favorites, like, and these are some of the things which we probably do, like clicks, keywords, comments, bounce rate, anything. To measure it. This is somehow a digital calendar looks like. So when, probably when you start doing social media, probably you need to see, you need to understand what all the channels are really working for you. Instead of a gentleman, you want to post something, right, about the child. So you need to understand what platform is really working for you. You should not post everything and everything, because people are spam. Sometimes what happens is people understand when you post something relevant on LinkedIn, don't post your pictures on LinkedIn. Some people simply put a selfie on LinkedIn, okay, not relevant. So you have to understand the right audience, the target audience, where you're putting this stuff. That anyways will come later on, what are the do's and don'ts. Okay, what are the agile ceremonies in social media world? Someone has heard about Google Accounts, Google Analytics, some of you, right? So, is it really helping you guys? Anybody wants to mention or share? Okay. So basically, what Google Analytics do, we understand the network, not the network, we understand the website traffic, where exactly it's coming from. Wherever your website is, you need to understand where exactly people are clicking, how many downloads are happening, where exactly the transitions are done. So that exact traffic analysis we get it from Google Analytics. Bitly is, it sounds like, it's kind of a leading for me. Why? Because you have huge URLs. How many of you really post those youth URLs and, you know, which ether most importantly, space? You have huge URLs. How many? That is really annoying for anybody. Like, we are agilists here. We need to understand how we can reduce the waste here. So, if you talk about Twitter, you only should use this between our Google Shopper so that you can reduce the waste on the first side and it can be more relevant. BufferApp.com. So, that was very nice when BufferApp.com hits you when you have content. Instead of you posting all the upload on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, you might post some content from your brand page or from your community, but you need to understand if it needs to go to you want to post a different way or one shot. So once you create a file, you can see this over here. So you have the content ready. So you can post it to different social media networks, and that's how it works for you. That is easier for a brand. You do not have to do a lot of brain hacking like that. YouTube social media dashboard. So usually nowadays you see a lot of events happening, live events happening. You know exactly what is being done. They're so agile, they do. It's again, the time cycle is they have adapted and they have inspected and now they have adapted. What happened is there were times when you were not able to tweet exactly the same time when the product brand is launching a mobile phone. Don't you think we should be very active? There should be a lot of social media on that. That's where when people have started using Hootsuite and a lot of social media dashboards, where they do tweeting, which is scheduled tweets. If you today also if you see Sony, for that matter, or any brand, they will do scheduled tweets. Schedule on Facebook also, so that you remind them like, when you're launching something, you should be in sync with the people. Some people might be talking about it. So there are some scheduled tweets going on. Okay. Applying agile principles. How many of you know about this idea? Which agile principle is this? Is it a principle? Yes or no? Yeah? Yeah? Can somebody say?
Work not done.
Thank you. So same thing as I mentioned before, how you can apply a principle over here is you do not have to post your content on your social media in all the channels. As a person, as a brand, or as a community, understand which those top three, do a parameter for that, top three channels will really work for you. For most of you, might be LinkedIn is the best part. Then you understand if I post on Twitter, I'm able to link all the agilists over here. Some of the agilists are already on there, I know everybody over there. Most of them are Twitter. How you connect with the community? Just on the line is on there. So you can connect with the database and all the people there, that internet, right? And that's how they. Today we spoke about using a hashtag. You know what is the importance of using a hashtag? Suppose a person who sits sitting in the Netherlands, he wants to understand what is happening in Scrum Bangalore today, and he wants to learn at the same time, he can actually see what all the learnings are putting there. Right? So simplicity in the social media world is understand your content, don't make it too huge, and don't post it in all the channels. See what all the channels are really working for you. Have a retrospection meeting. Understand these three channels are giving me a lot of revenue. Twitter, Facebook, etc. Okay, this sounds similar. What do you think it is? A chart principle, yeah. So what do we do here? At regular intervals, the team reflects on how to become more effective, and then gives an agentless behavior accordingly. What do we do here? It's better that. Some retrospections. Very important. Retrospections are key to anything and everything in today's world. Either you say you want to do it, either you say you don't want to do it. But that's very important. For social media teams, you need to understand what's working, what isn't working, and why. So it's not like I want to post all my tweets, and I have seen some of the channels in today's world. One day a week, they spam people like anything. You will have got 35 tweets or some 5 or 10 posts like anything. You will think, wow, what happened to them drastically? So that is spamming, and that's how the users, that's not agile. That's simply you vote up one day and say, okay, fine, I'm going to buzz everybody today. So understand what exactly is working for you, take the feedbacks, and understand that also what is not working for you.
We talked about building project around multiple individuals.
Does that sound familiar?
Yeah.
So how do you do in your environment, in your day-to-day work? Do you do those?
Do you build project around multiple individuals?
Any things what you do as a practice in your day-to-day? Anybody?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Talk to them.
What's going on
okay.
on their side?
Yes.
How you can help them?
Okay. Perfect. Agreed. Exactly. Same here. You need to first of all, you know, have trust in people. Have trust in people. Like in the social media things, what I know from people, they even allow them to talk to the customers. And then they get the job. Like, you know, if they're an individual on a team, you're passionate about interacting with customers and ability to highly visible and collaborative atmosphere. Let them write up and down. Sometimes it is good. It gives a lot of confidence to you, your team members, to drive out to reach customers to understand what exactly is required. In social media, you get very quick, feedbacks. Your client is right there, and I'm sure he's always watching the Facebook or whatever you're doing exactly. It's not that a software company where I'm expecting them. So the clients in social media are very active. They want to see exactly what is going behind. So there you get a quick feedback. You inspect quickly and you adapt. So even if you fail fast and then jump back. That is important. This is also a very important part of social media. Because we say in our world is continuous attention to social media etiquette and good interaction. Design enhances agility. Do you agree with me on continuous attention or social media etiquette? Yes or no? You know what happens? Sometimes you just spell something wrong and there are 5 comments on your social media posts, Facebook people pointing out, hey man, that is this. That is how people are actually judging your etiquette. Maybe. Some of them do. Some of them say, okay, fine, chill, no problems. And some of you might say, some people do that, I think. There was funny one, getting married to this person and scrolling 5 more people. And then, you do not do it purposely, but it comes up and says, you're getting married to 6 people. Come on. But anyways, that is, then you need to understand, you need to accept one of the basic etiquettes, spacing of course, that was wrong. And this again is one of the agile principles which we need to follow. Social space is agile, inspected a lot. How many of you are aware of Facebook Live?
Most of you.
Yes? How many of you have done already your Facebook Live?
Austin waiting for the golden moment when I have to put in this camera and start live and live.
It's okay, it's okay. Nobody's judging you over there. But yeah, some people do that, you know how you will look at that. It's fine. So that was a very quick move from Facebook. We understood that, how they inspected and adapted. You understand in today's social networks, if you do not do that, you're going to be out of the market. You understand output there. If you have no offense to output, but you understood, if it becomes monotonous, if it becomes so okay, everybody is doing it, it is out of the market. So Facebook is always inspecting and adapting. Zuckerberg was here, he talked to the people, he took a lot of feedbacks, And this was something which one of my friends who was in UK recently did, that we all know about in UK. And she says, I'm safe. She marked herself safe. That was a lot of things. Because not everybody, anyone and everybody can call each other who are not in that zone. But this indication means safe. That was Facebook, there's a quick feedback they took and they implemented. And this is something which everybody's liking also. How many of you are on WhatsApp? Oh, great. It's a crazy question, sorry. Everybody's on WhatsApp. But did you notice a recent change? Yeah?
Yes.
Status? How many of you are in that position?
Adding a new person.
Oh, yes.
A new chat.
No chat.
Earlier it was the top, now it's coming as a Google.
Yes. So you know what happened? They realized, they fail fast and they quickly understand that they were not doing right. There is a damn, who wants to put his picture? I want to put some message. They quickly fail fast and revert it back. That was very agile from them. They understood that. Not many people like it.
Yeah.
Instagram started, yes. So that was something of Snapchat. For me, it was kind of a Snapchat, Instagram. So Instagram, when exactly you see for a few seconds a picture. But not happening. So,
Facebook.
WhatsApp. But that was not taken in a very, way. Not many people like it. Just 2 seconds, I see a picture. If suppose your spouse is there and you see a picture, 2 seconds. Well, thank God, I'll change. But since you're not like it, hey, why my picture is going off within 2 seconds? I mean, again, a lot of people don't like it. But yeah, so this is something, a lot of agility is happening over here. A lot of inspection and action is happening over here. A lot of things where people fail fast and understand what is not working for them. And they are. And if you see that, it really happened within a few hours. Like in the morning, everybody was posting this message, and it's not happening for me. Yeah. Yes, some of you are already on Twitter. I don't know that much, but I want to tell you something which you can really can help. See, generally, these are some basic etiquettes. Along with that, this is how your basic hygiene works in Twitter. So basically, if you want to tag somebody, tag the right person. If you're tagging Jeff Sullivan, if you're tagging somebody who you are tagging, well, one of the agile leaders in the country, in the world. So make sure you tag the right person. Make sure you do an RT, whatever. If you want to do an RT, you do an retweet, that's a retweet. There are many charming services, like as I mentioned, you don't read on this thing. It's not putting those URLs, don't post it. Those are very annoying and it will eat on most of your space. And this is something, a hashtag, where probably as you understand why hashtag is working. So when one person starts talking on one point of the hashtag, it reaches everybody. So you are on the same link, same mindset. This will also help in Scrum, today's problem. Right, Albert?
Okay.
So, some of the tips for applying agile social media. Run campaigns of SNS in a sprint manager of a month. So, give reports to your customer. The problem with social media is the customer is always there. He's not like after 2 weeks he's coming back. He's your problem in 30 also. Hey man, the lights are not increasing. Hey man, somebody has posted like this. I'm getting all those messages. So basically, make him understand, you're following your 2 week sprint, make him understand that way. Sit with him, tell him we're following IWCR. You know that I'm crazy, but IWCR, all the manifestos, all the values, tell him understand that how they're going to work. So that is very important in this aspect. Retrospection meeting should be conducted after every campaign. So campaign in sense like, suppose today is an event also, think of it as a campaign today. So we want to reach around 1 lakh people in India. Are we doing that? How many impressions, some of you might be thinking, how many impressions it is generating? So that is something which we get from. Collaboration is encouraged, fail fast and learn, as you saw some of the examples over here. Use visual boards for hashtag tracking, Google Analytics. Customer collaboration that will contract the issue. So that is very valid. You can follow all this. You can do your own social media, you can follow your own channels, you might have your own companies, but you have to be very agile. Do not be very, like now, unfortunately, Twitter is becoming very monotonic. So they have to come up with a few changes, otherwise, next time if I'm talking, Twitter is not there. I'm not really sure about it. So inspect and map every product, so even product backlog. So I'm not sure if you're having a question backlog today. Usually in communities we do have a question backlog where you can post your questions. So have an event for a product backlog. Understand if you're doing a lot of events, maybe an event company, understand what are events you're doing and is it really small events? Because all your members are just like running. So in your event companies what happens is they're running for small events, which is not really actually helping you on you're getting the required ROI and it's not generally a lot then. So it's better than that for community events, I'm gonna talk about that. Daily Scrum meeting, 15 minutes events. Everywhere you should do that. I think that keeps available everybody and everybody on the same page. So this was something that really should work. A couple of years back, I used to run a student ambassador program in India. And this is how I used to call my team, and every month we used to talk, we used to do a retrospection after all campaigns. Yeah, we are not running. Students do a lot of events in colleges, but they are not aware exactly what is exactly creating value for them, or is it really helping out? Suppose you are doing a giant hackathon, or your hackathons, what exactly is creating value for students. So they, this was some key things which we need to understand, which really, you know, what are the campaigns you should do in colleges. Doing an Android workshop or doing a photography workshop, which will be more useful. Obviously, both of them, but what context and what relevance. That you need to understand.
I think there
are a lot of communities in Bangalore. So, not here to promote anybody. But what to do with communities now? Communities have become agile. Do you agree with me on that?
Yes.
Yeah? Yes? Tell me how they are agile. Enough talking. How are agile? Come on. Okay. Anybody else? Trying to think value. Okay. Anybody else? So, let me tell you something. See, basically, how we're agile. Let's talk about today's meetup. We do have a retrospection at the end of the day, right? So, we are not going to let you go like without your whatever thoughts you have. Whether we do learn what are the best practices that are made up. You have a questionnaire background where you can post your questions. You're dealing with all the intelligent interaction. If you're not meeting with a process driven process, you're able to talk to all individuals, understand what you can take. But we are becoming agile and we're expanding from probably what we've done wrong from the last changes. We're inspecting and adapting. We're also doing a lot of changes in sales. You're responding to changes following your plan. You do that. So this one is a endless interaction that I've already mentioned, but I have 4 minutes more. I think I'll be able to wrap it up in 2 minutes. It's like a rapid retrospection. Responding to change and following the plan, time boxing. So you understand the time boxing, the timer is already running.
I can't even be able to.
So that is the way we are agile in that sense. So question background, obviously, we have it. Question. I think I'm done from my part. And one thing I want you to do is believe in yourself, and probably, sometimes what happens is when we talk to individuals, as Anand mentioned, Billy Ryan, that you need to talk to your Scrum Masters or your Agile coaches, but people are there, because generally we feel like, what will this person think of me? Will he think that I'm not intelligent enough? So just have the confidence that whatever you're asking, even if it's a dumb question, it will meet relevance. You should do that. So, the last part which I want to do again to meet the way we started, just say to your partner next to you that we have excellence infused in you. Come on. You have excellence infused in you. Come on. You have excellence infused in you. Come on. Very people are not in that. What happens? Where are we talking? Yeah, come on. Right? So, I think questions, please.
So you talked about a lot of channels and platforms which are like for a product which is you want to sell in the market. But for example, if I have a product internal to the company, like a company intranet, which not people use it, but they don't know what is there, what's not there. Probably they don't want to use it, or any other product. So channels which you brought inside the company to promote such things are email, Skype, and Yammer. Yammer happen people don't use. Email, they ignore such stuff. And Skype, I don't know how you do it in message and track data. So what's your idea to promote stuff which is internal? What are platforms you can use in other data to track?
It's actually a brilliant question. See, basically, the same thing I'm doing with the pro also. So what happens is, my VP of XYZ division, he wants to, his word of mouth makes a lot of sense when he talks about, right? So there are social media, basically it's an integration. You have to do an integration within an organization. There are a couple of channels which are probably offline. So basically, you need to understand if you have them, so probably wherever platforms, you have to integrate Twitter and LinkedIn on that. So suppose your VP talks, he wants to, even he will be entering from it, whenever he wants to go to that channel, it will directly look like I was talking about one channel before, buffer.com. So basically, it's like an integration, right? So you have to get an integration coming within your company. So basically what that will do is basically, you have your Wipro channels, you have your other probably XML and company channels. So the integration needs to be done within your company, which will route all your people to different social media channels which you are looking for. That is easy. I think I will share this probably which all we are using. And that is easily possible. So we understand that Java and other things will not work to that level where you are looking for. So you need to do some of the integrations for them.
Where we integrate Twitter and other posts so that like the members of the Slack channel gets any notification once you post it on Facebook or Twitter, particularly with the hashtag pertaining to the community. Yeah. It is like you can have a channel created and then like you can add that distribution list which are the members that you want to send the notification. So it gets like whenever I post something, the hashtag of that company name or the group name, it gets triggered in the entire community. So everyone knows what's happening. Yeah. Yes, it will work. We will be like using.
Company to write a dynamic signal. Dynamic signal is one of the integrations which is used in the company. And very probably you as individuals, generally companies reward you people also because you're putting your work ahead. So dynamic signal is one which I know. And it is integrated with your Twitter, with your LinkedIn. So generally if my VP posts, he just logs into dynamic signal. And if you want to post, he just posts whatever he wants to say, whatever the revenues or something, whatever he wants to post. You can go to all the channels, the new channels. Some of the channels, like he mentioned something, and there are dynamic systems. And there are a lot of channels because nobody has time to individually post on that particular channel. So that is already there in place, but we have to get it integrated, provided how much it works like. Then you need to talk, take a channel, have a demo from them, and then start this talk with your people in your company. Okay. Okay. Yeah.
What's your opinion on critics and jokes with respect to social media ethics?
I think, if you are a brand, right, you're talking about individual stuff or your brand?
In general? I think you need to say relevance, I think, is something very important. Relevance, if you are a AIB channel, people will expect jokes, people will expect a lot of things. If you are a brand channel probably, if you are Ghana.com, people will expect some music which is that. So understand the relevance of your channels, understand the relevance of your target audience. Do be your touch person. It's not like I'm going to post about Ghana.com and movie which has come, and it doesn't make any sense for us. Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
One
thing, you have to take a joke. There's another way free channel. Just write a fine. And even there's a critic, there's a feedback for you to change something. So that feedback is given as a joke, as an anger, fame, it means
So you can play jokes, but maybe not very often. Like some people do play as a show, you can have a social calendar. So once in a week, like Motivation Tuesdays, Funny Fridays, inspire, like that. So you can come with a theme, your people will like it. It's not that you can't do a joke, but make sure the theme works with that. Like, motivation you cannot do a joke with it.
Yeah. One thing that is like being a social media activist, like we see like big personalities updating their Twitter account with supporting parties or anything, pretend to election or anything. It's your wall, and you have a right to post anything, unless and until it hurts the other personality.
That answers. Anybody else?
Yeah,
very friendly. Thank you so much for taking time.